Hey, how you doing? This is Kitch, and I'm here with Drake Hawkins, and we are playing Factorio.
Hello, everyone.
And I'm trying to remember what I was cooking up this copper line is what I was doing, and yes. I have belt.
I was doing all the iron.
And I think we have copper, too.
Yay. Resources. We can make things.
All right, and I think while I'm thinking about it, what I'm going to do is grab this belt-making facility and sure. Relocate it to a little bit better environs.
I'm going to temporarily put in a red belt, a red science maker over here. So I'm going to drop a gun down here and maybe a gun over here and give us some imitation defenses.
Okay, belt.
Science.
And
how many labs do we have up
here?
We're really kind of lackluster on the drills still, eh? On the iron? We're not...
Yes. Well, I mean, I think iron's okay, right? I know copper's not. I just barely put some... Okay. I put enough to get it moving.
I will upgrade the... Oh, you still have the iron going. Well, that's good. We left the research functional. I like that. I'm making some drills, drilling some stuff.
Why is this not working?
Coal. Or, whatever they're called. These things. The steam engine things.
And electricity would probably help that. Okay, now we have copper.
Do we have electricity shortages?
Oh, no, I forgot to put the pole. Works a lot better with the pole.
It does. Generally, electricity runs through lines. We haven't quite mastered the art of, what's it called? Projected,
bouncing it off the atmosphere or the ionosphere or whatever Tesla had in mind.
That's right. Tesla stuff. You know where I'm getting at. We speak the same language.
Alright, so I built this machine gun and I did not put any bullets in it.
That's useful. Speaking of machine guns and bullets... Way to go, turret. You only lost half of your health taking out those seven dudes. I think we need some military upgrade. He's at 246 of 400. Oh, I forgot how low their health is. Oh, that gun turret only achievement would be great.
11.
That is
11 kills on that one and 17 kills on that one. So, yeah, I mean, I haven't been paying attention much up here. Sounds like there's like a battle or war going on.
Kind of. The biters up top have been doing their have been putting us through the ringer.
We've got a couple off to the west. We're starting to hit them to the south now. All right, so things are about ready to get fun. At what point is it important to think about clearing, or is the evolution factor from clearing something you have to worry about in a death world?
Yeah, you need to push them back because. If they're outside the evolution, they are less likely to spawn on you. You know, you increase the evolution factor when you kill the bases. But to me, it's better to kill the bases, bump your evolution factor by a small percentage, and that way you actually don't die to the biters, basically.
Yes. Me, at some point, managing the evolution becomes less important than actually living.
Survival, yes. Survival first, please. Let's survive to talk about what we do with our killing your biters. Because essentially, you lose if you lose. Profound statements by Drake. When you lose, you lose.
All right.
I am
easily
cutting down beautiful green pristine trees because I need to build some chests. I guess I should make chests out of metal now, eh? That would be smarter. Let's do that. Let's use our wood to make power lines and make more chests out of metal. Oh, they changed how fast it is to lift up like tanks, like liquid tankers and chests and stuff.
Yes.
That always weirds me out when I try to build stuff and it's like, or you try to remove a wooden chest and it takes you like 20 seconds.
All right, I'm going to go ahead and just blueprint these guys, ghost them out to the full column size, just to have kind of a spacing thing.
Okay. I have no more stuff to put on the... No more drills to put in the facility to produce copper, but I have upgraded to replace, or to up our iron production to a better rate. We're gonna move you, Mr. Radar.
And it looks like I accidentally put my steel furnace blueprint down to do the marking. But awesome. That's fine.
Sounds effective.
Give us
oh,
goals.
That's bad. Oh, bad. That's really bad.
I don't like bad.
Bad is bad. Bad is turrets were destroyed. Bad.
Oh.
I let it run out of ammo. That's what happened, yeah.
I could probably contribute to that a little bit. What do I need? I need iron.
We have ammunition in a chest, so. What's it giving us? Only 27. Okay, so we're going to upgrade the ammunition rates. That would be lovely.
I'm getting blinks. What are the... Oh, that's probably the previous attack.
Likely, yes.
Man, what do those need? Oh, those need copper and iron.
There, and let's put in some more assembly machines. Turrets over here, and a turret over here. Let's do this. There.
Good, I can ghost and it costs a lot less. There we go.
Alright, so I'm upgrading the turret's defense to the north. It seems like that's where it's likely to hit us the most, because there's a desert there, and desert actually propagates pollution much quicker than the other type of terrains. Not sure if you were aware of that.
Are there... Is there something special about the desert, or is it just the fact that there's not as many trees there?
Well, the terrain actually acts, not just the trees.
The absorption rate, the terrain has an absorption rate itself?
The terrain absorbs, yeah. So grass terrain absorbs better than desert, and stone is the worst. Anything you pave...
Anything you pave, I know it that's not good for your pollution.
Zero absorption rate of pollution, which is fine if you have defenses, right?
Oh,
not so fine if you are depending on Drake rebuilding guns that he said he was going to and didn't. Got it. It's all covered, no problem. You have your ammo, right? Or your armor?
I have armor, okay. I have ammo, and I actually have some turrets here, and I probably need to be setting those up down here.
Yeah, I would defend them down south, because I've got the north covered pretty good. I'm pocket building some ammunition, because our machines just aren't cutting it. How many machines can we use to make these?
I usually start, like the first item on the bus, starting to do like circuits and gears and stuff like that. Oh, we're getting attacked down here, eh? Okay, turrets help a lot. All right, that was much better. I could have went a lot worse.
They save your life, these turret things.
Okay, so...
You were saying stuff on the bus first and stuff?
Yeah, I'm wondering if prioritizing like a little bit of a military area first.
Well, I was going to come down momentarily and build us some science. I'm going to go with like five. What do they produce at? Red is what? Five of them? I forget. I can do like one per second science off of our line to the west here. I'm just literally going to steal it and be a jerk and all that stuff. Like that, and just steal us some red, some iron and some copper. Oh, you've made space. Gotcha. That's what this is about. This is pre-spacing.
Pre-spacing that so you know how far it can go. So I was thinking coming over here taking the materials down and
I see. Yep.
Going straight down.
Okay. So I'll put this temporary red belt in still up at the top, because red belts are, or red science, we can, we'll replace.
We can always move it.
Yeah, we won't. I don't think I've ever kept a red science where it was initially placed. Actually, I might have in the last episode. Ugh. Entirely out of belts.
Just usually a recurring theme throughout my Factorio playthroughs is putting the disclaimer in. This is just temporary.
Yes, exactly.
It's all just temporary. By the time we get to where we're shooting a rocket off, that's when the starter base ends, right?
That's right. That's when you get into mid-game. To me, anyways.
I could start inserterating some things.
Inserterating. Now, there's a word I haven't heard. I need to check Urban Dictionary more often.
Oh, I got that spacing completely off.
Oh, yes, right. I'm doing this wrong. There, and you're going to...
I'm out of belt? No, I just can't find my belt. All right, that's there, and we'll bring power down. I don't have any wood, do I? No, I do not. Hey, there happens to be some trees right here.
I don't either, actually.
That one seems to be shading that turret, so...
Oh,
you took it out.
So sorry. That was rude. That turret is going to hate me forever.
Well, it probably won't be long till that tree is all dead and ugly anyway.
It is kind of sitting in a slightly less than... That's like in my city, Winnipeg. This was probably 10 years ago or so. They had like years and years where they had tried to get rid of or tried to make the trees work. Like I know a lady who works with the company that is responsible for keeping the trees and stuff and all the plants. You know, they put flowers down your main street in your downtown, all that stuff, right? And they had a heck of a time trying to maintain these trees. So about 10 years or so ago, these new trees appeared. They were iron.
Fake trees.
Made of metal. They made fake trees. Yeah.
Wow.
I'm like, that's great, guys. Thanks. Yeah. So that was the thing.
Yeah, we were over at someone's house not long ago, and you know, we have the big shade trees here. It's impossible to grow grass under them. I mean, everybody knows that, right? You have trees or you have grass. Pines, you get to pick one.
That's
right. And so her solution was to go and just completely astroturf her backyard.
Nice.
Ugh. And it looks really good, I guess. You know, it's a nice dark natural color. You kind of take a second take at it, but
it looks good until you look carefully.
Carefully.
Yeah.
Got a nice little bounce to it as you're walking across it.
Well, that's not bad. You gotta have the bounce in the carpet. I just looked at. Yeah, that's about right.
All right. I was going to make.
Doesn't need to run in on these. That's the problem. That's what I'm. That's the stupid I'm doing here. I'm building a red science, not really thinking it through. I'm like, man, how do I get the? How did I used to get the iron and the copper feeding to the science? You don't, Drake. You just don't. You just put those things in the stuff, and then it works. And you to there, and you swap, and let's give some power here. We got our powers, we got our coppers.
Oh, wait, what's the limitation on parts? Can you not make assembling machine? You can't make turrets in an assembling machine, can you? You have to have a blue one?
That is correct. You need a blue, yeah. Which we are just about teched on, in fact.
Oh, automation too, right?
Because I'm turning on the gears here, and then we'll have our red science.
Oh, look at that. We got science here.
Science! If I put those all to science, and then I put the belt to run along here, and then the things and the stuff, and we'll be good. That's the scientific term for all of that. Making things and stuff.
Making things and stuff till it's good. That's getting spit out.
You can go... You guys, why don't you, like, double turret down here? That would be lovely. There we go. I'm happy with two turrets. Ooh, look, extra turrets.
Speaking of that, I just built a ammunition-making plant down here, and wouldn't it be ironic if it were to get destroyed because I didn't put any turrets down?
Well, no, it's inside the turret range. Oh, no, it's not. Oh, just barely. It's kind of inside the turret above it, but not really. So I want to do this. I want to do a temporary... Did I just leave a gap there? That was weird. I did, apparently. Not necessary. Ugh. Drake, you fail at placing things sometimes. Excuse me, Mr. Biters. Who said you could blow up our base when we weren't watching?
Oh, my. Is that an unprotected area up there?
I appreciate the effort, but go away. Our copper is going to stop temporarily. Oh, no, the turrets took care of them. It's just out of range. They were charging after the drills, and then they kind of got...
Kind of got a little bit too close.
Just close enough to get in range of the turret. Oh, no, they took out one turret. That's what they did. So they were beating up one turret while the other turret was helping. You guys can do this. And we'll throw some not fast inserters. Just some regular ones would be nice.
Going to throw down the first official trash box here.
Yay! Where is it? I think I left my gun like sitting up north somewhere, so I can't participate, sorry. I feel hard.
I'll put my first pistol here.
Yeah. My first pistol.
I'm sure I may have some more generated as time goes on.
It's absolutely true how it works. We have ammunition here. We got 185 rounds. If you need some rounds, there's some rounds here now. Okay, you guys go there. Are you? Oh, you're out of metal. You're out of iron. That's why you're not doing anything. Right. About that. Let's do this. I'm going to be all tricksy here and put a coal mine next to our... Ah, I love it. There we go. And then,
Ah!
There you go. What up?
I met some friends.
You're getting
dead. my turrets took care of them.
Oh, good.
Just a little bit of shock. Wasn't really expected.
We are missing a turret, which to me indicates that we probably got it shot.
Missing a turret.
Yeah, it's gone. I seem to have missed the point at which it got destroyed. What do you think about shotguns?
I've tried to use them. It seemed like back they were really good for clearing out biter bases at one point. But yeah, I generally don't mess with them too much.
Yeah, I'm kind of in the same sort of train of thought. Oh, speaking of biters. Don't kill me! Go away, biter. Oh no! Drake's gonna die! Drake's gonna die! Die, creatures!
I'm running up
the
carnage! As
run!
Fast as I can. Ah, oh wow, you do have a little group of friends
Drake's
there, huh?
His butt
a little
cake.
Fan
yeah,
club.
This is Death World, folks. Not what I intended to do there at all. What am I doing?
What are we looking at here?
Nothing! Don't look! I don't know what you're talking about. I didn't do that.
I'll just go back down here.
Yeah, just go away for a second. You can come back in a minute. Whew, that was terrible looking. I hear the sound of biters still eating things.
They're that? Still flashing on the map.
They're still bite. Oh no, our iron. Oh my gosh. Okay, this is a little excessive. Death World has become a thing. Welcome to Death World. We just lost like 700 worth of iron.
Oh, our stone's gone, too.
Oh, yeah, our stone's gone, our guns are gone, half of our iron drills are gone. That was just a small little attack. Did you mean to put one way up north?
Was mean to put
up,
what?
Stone up there? You put a... Oh, that's guns. Oh, we need...
Those are guns.
There's stone in there. That's our only safe stone supply. We need that.
Oh, that is our only one, isn't it? Take that guy
unless
out.
You plan to dig up all the stone in front of the enemy base.
There's just one right up there to the northeast.
Yeah, just right over there. Now you know what I mean about spider bases. So this is why I think... Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. I think all of our turrets need to be doubled up. And one of the big things is once you get walls, we should probably do that after this automation is finished. Do we still have research going down south? How's it doing? I can't see because we don't have a radar coverage down there.
Let's see, it is not being made because we don't have inserters not inserting things, or uninserting things.
What did I miss? Okay, I want to see what I broke.
There's no output inserters.
And I didn't... Alright, I was doing that, and then we got attacked.
Then we got attacked. So you are forgiven.
Oh, phew. I will live to tell another story. And I guess what I actually wanted to do here is just... no, I want to do that. I'm going to go around here, and I'm going to go like this, and then I'll go like this. And then I want to do some more yellow inserters. That would be lovely. And then let's put our loopy loop belt. Oops.
Kind of advance the front down at... here.
Sorry?
Oh, I'm advancing the front.
Excellent.
Probably want to leave those guys. They have a tendency, it seems, to sneak into places where you would never expect them, so probably moving those wasn't the best idea, but
they essentially always kick my butt, so that's just normal for me. I only need 4 research labs, so 1 and 2 can go way off the list. Why do I have an entire half of my inventory full of stone? That seems a little silly. I'm going to put a chest down here.
Wasn't me. I didn't do that.
Yeah, I'm going to put a chest down here with stone in it. There you go. You got just because that's vitally important to keep stone randomly in your inventory. Jeepers. Radar. Let's put a radar in down here. Just so we can attract some more biters. Almost there. There's our last one. No? Did I not make enough?
Out of ammo. Should have a lot in the box down here, though. Ah, yes.
This guy looks like he got some attention, didn't he? Oh, you have a bus. It's so cute and bus-like. It's also just about dead.
Yeah, we had some problems down here.
I see. What have I been missing? All the fun. There's corpses everywhere. There's little... What do they look like to me? They look like a little... They're like those little... What are they called? Silverfish, worm things, whatever. And they're like doubled up on themselves. I don't know. I can't remember what I'm trying to say. I know what I'm saying in my head. That doesn't make sense.
We have some critters down here, and I'm not sure their scientific name. We call them roly-polies. They remind me a lot of those. That's one of those things, you know, I've lived this long in my life, and I have never looked up the real name for those things. It's just what we called them back when we were kids is what we call them now.
We have, I don't know if you're familiar with the term silverfish, but they're like those things that are in every house.
Yes.
In the galaxy.
Yes.
I'm pretty sure if Mars has houses,
they're in have silverfish.
Yes, they must. Because they're everywhere. So, look, we have researching. No, we don't. We have science finishing, but not actually researching. Let's go with, we could do logistics too, but that would require green. So let's go walls. The walls would be great. You know what would be great?
Surprised we haven't had that yet.
What would be also great would be to end our videos on time.
Oh, yeah, we are not good at that at all. You know, you gave me this thing that's flashing red over here on my other monitor, and I'm still not even noticing it.
Yeah, let's play timer. It's fantastic for those let's players that actually care. Oh, look at this. This is how we're going out. Our power's going down right now. Right now it's going down. Yep. Hello, biters. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. And next episode, we'll actually build some power.
All right. Well, give us something to do.
That they hit hard there. Like, they just ripped that apart. Wow. Mm-hmm. I saw a wall coming in. It was lucky that I happened to be heading in the right direction when it appeared, because that was a little unpleasant. We should do these, what are they, walls. Like I do, this is how I do my walls. I do, here, they'll build right away and I'll be fine to look at it. Yes. I usually do the one space away from them, circle. Right, like you do kind of, you encompass your guns. The one space means that the medium biters and up don't actually tear
don't,
your turrets.
Don't have the ability to hit them, right?
Yeah, they have splash damage. Essentially, they hit more than one. They hit more than one square. So,
all right, now we just need those everywhere.
That's right. We need to do that 100 more times.
Oh, we.
Hey, wow, that was a lot of damage. Well, I'll repair this. Are you're doing the outro, right?
No, you are.
I am. Well, I can't do an outro and do things at the same time. What do you expect of me? All right. Well, this is Drake Blunders 101. Thank you all for joining us. I guess we'll put in a cut here and we will put our buildings in the right places. That'll be next episode's epic challenge. But thank you so much for joining us. We have that's episode, what, three?
Three.
There you go. Through episode three. So hopefully you guys are enjoying the series. If you are, it really helps if you hit a like button on the new episodes. That really helps us know, A, that you like it, and it also helps YouTube know that you like it, and others might join us. So if you are new to my channel, thank you so much. In the descriptions, you can get a link to Kitch's channel and some great content over there as well. But thank you so much for joining us, and as always, we'll see you in game.